Hello and welcome to the SBC and Showbie Learning Journals training for the early year setting. This is a professional learning package of three pre-recorded sessions, and this is video number 2 of 3 for you to watch in your own time. Hopefully you'll have caught the first one, which will be on our YouTube playlist. And then after these videos, there's also going to be an opportunity to meet face-to-face at some Showbie support and sharing practice sessions, which is very hard for me to say, at some locations across the borders. And those locations are here. So we've got Peebles, we've got Eyemouth, we've got Jedburgh and Tweed Bank. You can book these on Business World as well, so please make sure that you do just that. The reason that we're doing these is following our early year Showbie training sessions we delivered last year. We took on board the feedback from these and it was felt that the online sessions were quite fast paced. So we're going to do some shorter pre-recorded sessions to allow you to pause throughout the presentations and try out Showbie on another device at the same time as you watch. Throughout this presentation, do feel free to pause or replay any parts that you feel you need to. Go at your own pace and have the opportunity to pause the video so that you can have some time to reflect. There's also these locations for the in-person support and sharing sessions too. You will only need to attend one. It is the same session 4 times. But if you do want to come to more than one and see all three of us in person and get our autograph, then you're more than welcome to do just that. We do ask that you sign up on Business World to access these sessions though, because it'll give us an idea of how many of you will be there and also give the settings some ideas of how much space we're going to need for them. These sessions will be an opportunity for you to share your practice with other people, learn from other practitioners, engage in some Q&A sessions, and also ask your troubleshooting questions to the team. And the little team that we've got today for you, we have on my right, Kirsty Banks. We have, and who she is, our Inspire Cluster Support in early years. We have Kate to my left, and she is our early years teacher team. And I am Roddy Graham, Inspire Learning Lead Teacher and Apple Professional Learning Specialist.
So here we are. Let's just recap. The first session was a real focus look on family partnerships, revising what it means for to establish an effective family partnership and how Showbie can facilitate that. Whereas this week, we're really specifically looking at that second arm of Showbie, and that's the classes function. How can we use Showbie to create a digital learning journal? So the third session, which will be the third video, is really looking about how we can involve the children in the actual documentation process using Showbie, making learning visible, facilitating the children's independence in using it. And of course, as we said before in our first video, it's about giving the children this introduction to using the functionality of Showbie, these skills that then will feed them and be best practice for moving on through the school as they move on to document their own learning. Just to reiterate again, that digital technology in the early years must support children to be active participants in their learning, and we hope that all the information that we provide in these sessions will facilitate you beginning that journey in your setting. So our session 2 aims with regard to learning journals. It's to really look at why learning journals themselves are important. Really consider what you have in your settings, what's working well with them, and again, how we can replicate that in a digital format. We'll walk you through the technical aspects of how to set up a class. And remember, in our last session, we were looking very specifically at groups. This is taking a real focus and spotlight on the class function of Showbie. We'll also be signposting you to case studies that really exemplify how it's being currently used in the Scottish Borders. And again, we may well be using terms such as learning journals and learning journeys interchangeably, but they are the same thing. There's also now a Showbie page on the Early Level portal. This page has the key messages and walks you through the technical aspects in more of a step-by-step approach. And whenever you see that portal icon, visible now at the bottom right hand of the page, then you'll know that there is more information on this topic available on the Scottish Borders Council Early Level portal. You can scan the QR code with your phone camera in the corner of the screen, and it will take you directly to that page that is illustrated. So, for example, on this page, scanning the code will take you to the Learning Journeys page. Ensure that in settings under the camera app that you are available, you have actually granted access to scan QR codes with your camera. So, learning journals with Showbie. Learning journals. Let's have a really close look at why they are so important. You can find out more about learning journals and the key SBC key messages around these, further reading the National Guidance on Learning Journals page of the Early Level Portal. Again, scan the code on this particular clip, and that will take you direct to that page. Some key pieces of documentation. We're looking here at the Education Scotland's Engaging Families and Parents document. This is a toolkit for practitioners. It's available on their website and it's broken down into many different sections. This particular quote we think is really appropriate for when we're looking at our use of Showbie in creating these digital learning journals for our children. And it really focuses on the child's progress is reliant upon them sharing their learning. To identify and develop effective methods of reporting and communicating to parents. And we all know that some of the challenges in our documentation are some of those barriers that might be up against us, be it with logistically sending photos to printers, printing them out, sticking it into files, whereas we're hoping this way will be much more streamlined with Showbie, much more quick and much more efficient. And we are able to engage the parents with that so that they are aware in real time of their child's progress. And on to realizing the ambition. That there is actually quite a chunky section about the use of digital technology at early level, which is something that we often miss in realizing the ambition, particular focus to actual children's progress and what they actually require in our settings. But this is just as an important part as getting our environment right. Many settings we know across SBC and nationally use a variety of different platforms for communicating to parents. These might be blogs, they could be e-portfolios, but also email and Facebook groups. But it is actually very important that we try and deliver a method where the children are engaging with these. Many of our Facebook groups, it's a tool for communication for us as adults to our families. Whereas Showbie is going to give us that platform that not only is very quick, very efficient, very easy to do that communication and to document in a method that may well have taken us several steps by doing it the long road in paper form, but that parents are also involved in seeing this in real time with the children's voice captured. They can be in charge of which photo would you like to share. And again, as Roddy has coined with some of our trial schools last session, it was sharing to Showbie so that the children are in control of how they communicate their learning both at home. Now, both systems, both paper and digital, they definitely have their place. And as a setting, and what Kirsty discussed in our first video, when you're discussing your rationale about how you're going to make this move to the digital platform, how it's going to be incorporated into your practice, to consider the value of actually having some sort of paper copy, a paper scrapbook, somewhere where the children still can record some of their own examples of work and a hands-on method. But again, also looking at what the benefits are of going digital. And again, that children are going to be involved in that side too. So again, it's about discussing as a team, recognising the value of both, and thinking about what that's going to look like in a method that is efficient and not duplicating. We do not want a situation where we have both things happening concurrently. We're going for efficiency here.
So we're now going to have a look at the classes function on Showbie. These are a one-way communication tool, so parents are not able to comment on the content that you post, and they can't post it to themselves either. Going forward, there is going to be a way around this, which uses QR codes, but we'll cover this in session 3. What we're going to do is we're going to have a look at how to create a class using the classes function, how to create multiple classes, how to create assignments, how to set up folders within a class, post within a class, and how parents can download their posts as well. And if there's some more ideas that come to mind whilst we're doing it as well, we might get onto those too. So first up today, we are going to guide you through how to create a class using the classes function. So in your microwave menu, if you tap on all classes, you will then get a list of every class that you have. But if you don't have any, then there will just be the sample class that you get when you first sign up to Showbie. The spanner menu gives you these choices here. So if you are joining a class that already exists, you press join a class, you type in the class code, hit join, and you'll either get straight access or you'll be given it once you've been approved to join. The one that you're doing if you're wanting to set up a new class though is to come into new class. You're going to name your class in here, so it could be the name of your setting, ELC, and then 2223, depending on the year that you're working in. You're given a class code, and with the class code, when you click on it, you are then given the registration options. So it could be open, that when students put in the join code, they get straight away access, or it might be by approval that you want to approve them in first, or it can be closed as well, where you're not allowing anyone else to join. Because you're in a nursery setting and it'll be you that is basically joining them to the class, put it in as open, and that'll be just hunky-dory.
Can you rename the class once you've set the name? So say if you change your mind about what you want it to be called.
Yeah, you can reset the name anytime you want. I can show you that in a wee moment. What's also quite good for the little name section is making use of the emojis as well. So for example, at Tweed Bank, we've got a group that are called the Owls and the Deer. So we've got an owl emoji and a deer emoji in there just so that it shows you the difference between that class and our squirrels and our foxes.
And if you're using a desktop computer, you just right-click in that text box and it will give you the choice of emoji at the top, and that's how you insert the emojis from a desktop or a laptop.
You also have some additional options in the new class area. Student-led portfolios is generally used in the upper school, whereby they have multiple assignments for the different pieces of work that they've got, and when they want to choose their best piece of work, they can pop that into their portfolio that way. Because the way that most learning journeys work digitally with Showbie is the portfolio anyways, so you can turn it on if you want to, but I would probably just suggest to turn it off.
I have said to a few settings, however, if we're recording a wow moment that the child feels is particularly significant to them, rather than we know what's significant and what's not for the child, but what they want to record and what they are proud of, it could be a good thing tool to use. So it just depends on your setting and how you use it.
Great. The last one you will want to turn on through time. So this is the parent access to have access to the digital learning journey. If you turn it off to start with, that is fine. They can still view the child's portfolio section only, but through time, once you've maybe got 4 to 6 weeks worth of evidence there for to share with parents, turn that to green and you'll be good to go.
The parent access is also very useful if you are planning just to use the group setting. You can link parents to the children through your Welcome to Showbie class and toggle that off, and all the parent will see that they are linked to the class, but they cannot see the content, but they can then join your class communication group.
Brilliant. And all you need to do is, once you've got your name and thing in there, press save and that will generate your new class. Since Kirsty asked, I'll just show you in Learning Journals by Curricular Area. If you click on the class, and if you click on the spanner you have to press. If you come into Settings for the class, you then see the name is up here, and then you can edit it into your heart's content and press save, and it'll update those changes. So now we're going to guide you through the process of how to create an assignment within Showbie. I am aware that the word assignment is very formal, but really it's just a space to put evidence in. So you can see here that there are 5 different assignments here. We've got Term 1, Term 2, Term 3, Next Steps, and Developmental Overviews. Each of those is just a different section within the learning journey. So to create a new one, you need to go up to the spanner again and press the New Assignment section. You can give it a name, so let's just call this one Term 4. What emoji would you like for Term 4?
Oh, something summery.
Sun, there we go. And you've got a due date on it if you want to turn that on. So if you are saying you can only put things into this assignment up to a certain point, you would turn it on. Generally though, we suggest that you turn those off because you can add anything at any point. Student access, you probably want it to be editable if you're using the QR codes at some point for them to put their own markings onto Showbie. And that's the only options that you've got. So name a wee emoji if you'd like to, turn the due date off, set that to editable, hit create, and it will make that assignment.
Now, there's one aspect of the whole layout there that now upsets me, Roddy.
What's that?
It's the fact that term 4 is not next to term 3.
I know, right. That so, and even if I click and drag it, I can't move it up. However, there is this edit button at the top. So if you press the edit button that's there, you can see these little three-line menu options. If you then click and drag that, you can put them into the order that you would like to do so. Hit done. And voila!
Oh, I'm much happier now, thanks.
I know you can't see her on this video, but she is beaming beside me, I can tell you that.
I can hear her smiling.
So that's how you create an assignment. It's very, very simple to do. If you want to change the names at any point, so say, for example, you don't like the sun emoji, you can hit that spanner again, assignment settings, and you can change until your heart's content. So when you create an assignment, you'll notice that there are no children listed there. But if you click onto the assignment that you've created, that's where you get your list of children. We'll talk a bit more about the shared item soon, but you can see that the pupils are listed below, and that works for every assignment that you put onto Showbie. In order to see your pupils, you need to click on the assignment itself. In this example that we've got here, we only have assignments. So this has been created so that each learning space is for a different part of the journey. But it is possible to set up folders within a class as well and have multiple assignments in a single folder. So another example of that is this one here, Learning Journals by Curricular Area. So you can see here that we've got folders set up for literacy, for numeracy, health and wellbeing, and some other sections too. If you want to go down this route, it's very simple to do. You tap on the spanner again, but rather than going new assignment, you can create a new folder. So if we call this one, just for example, My Best Work, which I know that some settings are using, we can pop a wee thumbs up in there too. We can see that that creates that folder with the title of My Best Work. You can then have assignments within that for different learning aspects. So it might be My Best Work in Numeracy, and you would call that one Numeracy inside that folder. What you can't do yet, we have suggested it to Showbie, is folders within folders. Whether it happens or not, it'll be a Showbie decision, not an Inspire and Early Years decision.
Can I ask, in the folders, so we've got literacy there, and again, our key message for when you're replicating what you do in paper format is to try and keep it the same. That keeps it streamlined as long as it's working well for you in your setting. But within literacy, that is just the folder. The assignments allow you to split it into time. So unlike the learning journals by term, that's the holistic approach where it is just chronologically the children's learning is listed. This allows you to be more specific about the child's literacy progression in term 1, in term 2, in term 3. It would also be worth mentioning that although this is a folder entitled Literacy with three assignments inside, meaning that you could very quickly see that child's learning in term 1, term 2, term 3, you may prefer a more chronological approach, and in which case an assignment entitled Literacy would allow you to see the child's entire literacy learning progression in one assignment. So it's really trying to consider what you are currently doing in your paper learning journal and replicating that with using the folder option if required.
So the next thing we're going to look at is how to make some posts within a class. So to make a post, you have to be on a specific assignment. So for example, here we've got our literacy folder. The assignment is term 1. So I am now going to be making this post on term 1. You will see at the left-hand side, it says shared items. Now shared items is a powerful tool, but you do need to be careful when you're using it, because the shared items means it can go to every single person in your setting at once. Or you can make it specific to a smaller group. But what we suggest is when you're doing an individual thing, you go onto the individual child's name. So we'll start with Ben in here. You can see that I'm on Ben Thompson's assignment in literacy for term 1. So we know that this is the space that we're writing in. Just like the groups that we saw in last week's video, the space says write a comment. So if you were doing an observation or a plod, you call it?
Possible line of development.
Excellent. So if you're doing those, you can type those away to your heart's content. You can hit enter when you're ready to make a new line and then press post when it's ready to go. But Just like we saw in last week's video with groups, you're able to add more things in as well. So if you want to import a document, maybe you've created a digital book or a digital presentation, you can put a copy of that into Ben's work. You can go to your photo library and choose a photo or a video that's already been filmed or recorded, and that can be added in as well. There is also a built-in camera too. So if you want to hit the camera, you can take a photo directly on Showbie and it'll pop that photo in as well. You also have the option for voice notes, screen recordings as well. Grades you probably won't want to use, but you can mark pieces of work as well. But those are the options that are there with the plus button. They are extremely simple to use. I'll just show you a very quick example of the photo library one. So if I tap on that, here are all my photos that I've got. I'm just going to choose this one, which is of a maths presentation that I was at. So it's not to do with early years, obviously. If I press done, I can then crop it if I want to. So if I want to size it down a little bit, I've got the option to do that. I can rotate it, I can move it in whichever way I want to. And then all I need to do is press the tick at the top corner, and that will upload that to there. Now, for some reason, that's not worked. It may be to do with the internet connection that I've got in the place that I'm working today. I've maybe not signed into the guest Wi-Fi properly, but that should send away, and then you're able to open it up. What I'll do is I'll go into one that does have some things in it. Here we are with Emily, for example. So you can see that Kate has written this comment in here. She's put some emojis in too. And you can do as many edits of that as you want. So for example, it was posted on May the 3rd and it was achieved later on in the session. Okay.
Roddy, could you just explain what that red circle means when a child's got that next to their name?
Yes, the red circle means that there has been teacher feedback given to that child. So when there is a red circle, it means that there is something as part of that assignment. The other option that you will find in Showbie from time to time is a paperclip. The paperclip means that the child themselves has attached something to that assignment. So if children are sending in with the QR codes and they take a photo of their work, they will come up with a little paperclip, and that is what the symbol is for. So I've came into Ben's assignment here, and you can see that there's a good observation that's been written in there, but we've also got this photograph that's here too. Something that you're able to do, and we're going to cover this in the third session, is annotations on top of things like photos. So what we can see if we tap on this photo here and let the annotations load is there is a voice note attached to this photo, as well as a comment that's written in text form too. You can have as many of these dotted around a single photo as you want to, and we'll show you next week how you're able to do them. What we suggest is if you put an emoji, something like a magnifying glass or something that means it shows to parents, if you click this photo, you will find out more information that when they tap on it, they will then be able to see and hear lots of other different things. But we'll cover how to actually create that in the next session. So although parents will have access to Showbie via their account, they may want to take some photographs offline and use them in other various ways by having them in their own photo library on their devices. The quickest and simplest way for them to do that is if they go onto a photo that is there, and if they just hide away the little comments that might be on it, the little annotations, just take a screenshot of it. So on an iPad or an iPhone, it's obviously the power button and the home button. On other devices, it'll be in a different way, but then they can have a digital copy of the photographs that are on Showbie.
And just be mindful that, as would happen at any school event, if you went to a sports day, if you are taking photos of your child onto your own mobile, just be mindful not to share them on social media.
Yeah, and it is important to note as well that parents only have access to their own child's learning journey. They cannot see any other learning journeys because of the way that it's set up with these unique join codes.
That's true.
So when using Showbie for learning journals, you should start by thinking about how you can transfer the layout of your current learning journals into Showbie. So if the layout of your current learning journal is working for you, there is no need to change the format. For example, if you normally divide your learning journals up by curricular area, it might be a good idea to do this on Showbie. Or if you use a learning stories approach, consider how this could be documented using Showbie. Just reflect on what you've learned during our two training sessions so far, and how you could use the groups and classes assignments function to work with your current format. This will be easier for everyone involved to get used to if you keep that consistency on the format.
So, but if you would like any support doing this to try and achieve the format and the look that you want, please just do get in touch. So the key messages around learning journals, observations, next steps, stay exactly the same when using Showbie. Even though the platform that you are using to record these is different, the content should stay exactly the same. So have a look, if you want to kind of remind yourselves of those key messages, you can see the learning journals and observations pages on the early level portal for more details on those key messages. And whatever your current processes are in your learning journals, keep these the same when you move to Showbie as well. So not only just the format, the overall format, but actually the content and the systems you have to share information with parents, keep those consistent. It allows teams and the parents to keep that consistency of kind of process that they use when they're posting. So these may include, but are not limited to, any signposting you currently use to denote the different types of entry. So for example, some people use a speech bubble for the next steps or a particular observation. Some people use a star to denote an achievement. You can continue to do this through the use of emojis on Showbie. And even for well-being indicators and things like that. Any links to the curriculum you might include in your current learning journals, they can also be marked using emojis such as coloured squares some people use, or you could write out the codes for these as needed. So observations, as we would say with any observation, wherever it's kept, they should be dated, significant to the child, taken in a variety of contexts. They should be written clearly and in an unbiased, non-judgmental way. They're consistent with other practitioners' observations. They might mention how the practitioner supported the child in the moment and might use evaluative language to quantify the adult's level of support. They might describe skills, knowledge, or understanding that the child has demonstrated, or they might describe an interest that can be extended. You might also include ways on the post that parents can support and extend that learning at home. And some other observations might be linked to input from a partner agency. Leadership, again, as with your paper learning journals, leadership should moderate Showbie posts regularly, just as should be done, as I've said, with the paper ones. Just to check for that consistency of entries between practitioners, the frequency of entries, etc. So some settings use a monthly record sheet to keep a track of who and hasn't had an observation. In terms of which children have or haven't had an observation, that might be something helpful that you might want to do. As with learning journal paper ones, parents should be able to contribute. So when parents are signed in with their parent account, currently parents don't have an option to contribute to their child's learning through a class or assignment. However, as we said in the last session, they are able to comment on any posts on the groups function. So if they were to sign in, so if you had a group, they can comment on that. If they were to sign in as their child using their login details or a QR code from their child, we'll discuss that in the next session, they could then comment as the child. It might work best initially to allow parents to have their own account and engage with Showbie through their own account at first. They're actually also able to see their other, if they've got other children in the school, they get to see, they get the two or three children or five or whatever children along the side if they sign in as the parent. When you sign in as the child, you only see that single child's information. Maybe start with a parent account. You can move to that signing in as the child later on. Ensure that the trackers are locked when you are sharing tracking information, just so that you only have practitioners contributing to trackers rather than parents. In learning journals, it's important to record children's achievements from within and without the setting. Again, this could be done using the groups function if you have individual groups with parents, or can be done when the parent signs in as their child. Individual achievements might clog up your general group page and could result in parents having a plethora of posts about other children's learning. So it's important to really understand what the parent sees and consider how you might want to best set that up. So again, children are involved in their learning and can access their learning journal easily. This is something that we always promote in terms of the paper learning journeys. So just consider and plan how you'll do that with Showbie. Our next session goes through how you can support children to be more independent using Showbie, using the QR codes, and taking time to teach them how to use Showbie. So we'll talk about that in the next session. In terms of your trackers and developmental overviews, just consider if and how you might like to integrate these with Showbie. If you do choose to integrate them, you could integrate a shared OneDrive file for practitioners to use. Some settings do that. Or you could upload trackers as a PDF onto Showbie and edit that PDF to highlight when they have achieved something or not. Or some settings have just kept that paper copy going on and keep them separate from Showbie. It's up to you, really. You just have to decide on that as a setting. If you include the child's voice on Showbie, you'll be beginning to understand how you can do this. Consider what Rod has talked you through today. You could scribe for the child. You can take a video of them, record their voice. Again, just capturing the child's voice can be done through supporting them to be independent with Showbie, which we'll discuss in the next session. And in terms of links with care plans and chronologies, where appropriate, observations should reflect entries in the care plan or chronology. For example, a photo of the child with the preschool home visiting teacher or the child working on the next steps identified by a speech and language therapist, those kind of scenarios. Or the chronology might state that the child has begun potty training and the learning journal celebrates their first successes with that. So as we touched on in the last slide, some parts of the learning journal will continue to work best on paper. Children need to be seeing adult modelling writing with pen and paper and have that experience for themselves to mark make in the floor book or on paper or in a busy book or a jotter themselves. So just, I want you to pause in a second and consider what parts of the learning journal might continue to work best on paper if you're implementing Showbie. Or if you're using Showbie currently, could you have a think about and then note down parts that you continue to use paper for. So now you've reflected on this, here are our ideas. You might have thought of some of these or had some other ideas that we've missed. And if so, I've said this before and I'll say it again, we'd love to hear about them. We're always on the lookout for new and exciting ways that you're using Showbie to make it work best in early years. So what have we got? Trackers. All About Me. You might have your drawings and paintings and mark making from the children. We did mention trackers earlier when we were talking about how you might store them. So some settings do still store them on paper. Your All About Me might be on paper as well for the moment, although we are looking at ways to make that more electronic and collate your details from all the children into one place. Some people have My Big Idea sheets that they still keep on paper. Your learning walls, obviously, will be on paper, and you might have a floor book as well still. So I'd like you to have a think now again, pause the presentation, about what you see the benefits of Showbie being. Do you remember any of the benefits that were included in the videos from the last session? And if you have started using Showbie, have a think about what the benefits have been so far. So now you've reflected on this, here are some of our ideas. You might have thought of some of these again yourselves, or you might have had some other ideas that we've missed. So again, we'd love to hear about these. So it's fast. Roddy noted that it took at least 20 minutes to write up a paper observation, transfer the photo taken onto a computer, print it off, cut it out, stick it in with the relevant observation. With Showbie, it took 90 seconds. So it's really fast. Portable, you can easily take the iPad home without having to use a range of resources to record learning, like your scissors and your paper and your pens and your rubbers and your glue and things like that. There's also a benefit for working in the setting. You only need an iPad to enter an observation into a learning journey. It's editable, so you can edit posts as you type and it picks up spelling errors, which is always handy. This takes away the enormity of writing an observation and having to restart if you make a mistake. You can reread it and edit easily and efficiently, and you don't have to worry about whether someone can read your handwriting or not, which is an issue I sometimes have. A variety of media. Again, you can put videos. We've said this before. You can put videos and voice notes onto Showbie. This is something that we're simply unable to do using a paper learning journal. And as we're working with children who are unable to read and write, this method of documentation is invaluable for capturing learning from the child themselves, and including the child's voice. Multiple, so really good for Showbie, this comes with a caveat, really good for posting something to multiple children. You might have been engaged in something, some sustained shared thinking together with an adult, so you're able to post one observation, or one picture, I should say, to multiple children at the touch of a button. This is the fraction of the time that it would usually take. However, this is the caveat, be careful to ensure that each entry is significant to that child. If it was only significant to one child, then it should not be posted to multiple children. Similarly, if the observation was significant for one child because they have never counted to five before, and significant for another child because they rarely participate in group discussions, the picture can be shared to multiple children, but the comment will need to be different to reflect on the individuality of that child's experience. So I hope that makes sense. But we must ensure that a child's learning journey is personal and significant to them. Showbie allows you to innovate your practice around learning journals and allows you to do things with these that you have never been able to do before. So using the tools on Showbie means you're keeping pace with current modern technologies. And one inspector said that in order to achieve an excellent rating in a care inspector inspection, you have to demonstrate innovative practice. Showbie is one of the ways that you can do this.
So just like in our first training video, there is a case study this week as well. I visited Kirk. We recorded a wee video with them. Now the sound quality is a little bit hard to hear, and that's because 3 and 4 year old children were present in the video, and as you'll know, they can be quite noisy at times. So feel free to watch it a couple of times to make sure you can hear all of Sarah's notes and all of our conversation. And use the QR code to scan that, as you see on screen, to watch the video on YouTube. But we'll also post the link in the description for you as well. And here's another quick reminder of our group code. If you'd like to join our Showbie Share and Practice group for practitioners across borders in ELC, just sign into your Showbie account, click on the Groups tab, click the little spanner that appears, choose Join a Group, and enter the code D8F33, and we'll approve you as a member of that group. This has been well used this past term by practitioners across the borders for both technical and pedagogical support using Showbie from ourselves and also from each other, and we'll hopefully use it in various different ways as the session goes on.
So hopefully in this session we've been able to achieve our aims that we'd wanted to. Feel free to pause the presentation at this point and just have a read through those. So in session 3 we're going to be looking into how to use Showbie to make learning visible, how you can use Showbie to document and reflect on learning with the children, as well as support independence in them using it. We hope you found today useful and that it gives you a good foundation to start or enhance your Showbie practice with learning journals. Any questions, just please do get in touch. There are email addresses there. You could use the Showbie Sharing Practice Group. Just get in touch. We're always happy to help. And again, here's the structure of the professional learning package we've got here for Showbie. And you can see the locations at the bottom. You just need to attend one, although we'd be happy to see you at more than one if you found them useful. Just please sign up on Business World to access them, as it gives us an idea of who will be attending and what space we have as well. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed the session today, and hopefully see you soon. Bye.